Friends, good morning everybody. This is Shyamal here. So I'm speaking after a long time. See, a lot of friends, they have asked me that what to do in life, what kind of business is good for growth. So I am a technocrat, so I deal with technologies related to various issues associated to global warming, simulation model, control, automation, all kind of technologies related to sustainable agriculture, global warming. So many things that I am dealing. But there are so many friends, they are qualified friends, they are PhD, they are doctorate, they are scientists. They are chartered accountant, they are biotechnologist, some are from normal field. So they want to do something in their life. Sometimes they feel they want to have the business. So they don't like to get into job and other things. Some are in jobs, so they are secure. Some are not getting job. There is a situation, there are a lot of qualified people. Since there is a restriction of government job, so they are struggling. They want to get into the business entrepreneurship. So they always ask, you give me a solution which is totally risk-free. If I invest money, your money should not be waste. So I do not have any other idea or no idea that you do any kind of business, you have to take certain amount of risk, and that is always there, and that kind of stress or sustainability or whatever things you need to take up to that level. If you even fail also, you need to accept this thing very heartily, or you can take this as a challenging kind of thing, then you can have newer idea. So even if you have one or two or three idea, one idea, if it is not succeeding, then second idea, maybe third idea might click. So there is a risk involved, obviously, when you are into kind of a business ideas that you are trying to implement. Now the question is, if somebody is asking me, I want to have a 1.1 solution where there is no risk, so I have a very, very good business proposal for them. I have prepared long back, around 4-5 years back, I have given my opinion that how to have a very kind of risk-free business. You can be 100% assured that you are going to get very huge amount. My project proposal is, if you invest close to 2.5 to 3 crores rupees annually, you are going to get 70 lakhs rupees in 4 years down the line. Your entire money will be recovered. Now, another 100 years, your life, your next generation, third generation, fourth generation can enjoy. So no business can give such kind of enjoyment. Friends, I am going to talk about that business plan. That business plan is very simple. You make a temple, a spiritual place, professional way, you manage it. You see, there will be a business. So first of all, you need to select a place where you want to establish the temple. Ideally, not very expensive land. You should be far away from the locality. You buy 2-3 acres land where people can go with struggle, because if your God is close to your home, nobody wants to go and pay visit over there. So you always, your temple or any spiritual place, it is located either in a hill station or in a very isolated place where you have to walk down and struggle to reach up to that God. Now In India, there are many places you can get cheaper land. Let's say you buy 2 to 3 acres land. Each acre land is 15 lakhs or 20 lakhs rupees. You spend 60 lakhs rupees. You spend on infrastructure, temple, masjid, and whichever dharma you are doing business. Doesn't matter you are belong to which dharma or not. It doesn't matter at the end of the day. Or girja or church, whatever you want to make, you make it. Try to have little analysis that where and what type of things you want to establish. This is number one. You spend 50 lakhs rupees on land. For structure development, spend another 1 crore or 1 crore 50 lakhs rupees. Ideal, Danpurti, Mandir and all those things. Annually, you keep 50 lakhs rupees, very highly qualified, talented people like MBA, engineers, maintenance engineer. There will be a residential complex where you can accommodate people. Now, you need to also, those are the investment. I'm talking about the land for 50 lakhs rupees, the infrastructure development 1.5 crores. It comes to 2 crores, another 50 lakhs annual salary package that what I have referred, MBA, 5 to 6 lakhs rupees. You make a Purohit in Sanskrit, MA in Sanskrit, all those things, graduate people you. There are a lot of surplus people you can recruit. There are accounts people. Annually 50, 60 lakhs rupees you spend for the administration part for managing the show. Now, you will see the inflow of money. You put the advertisement, spirituality, lot of songs, music, lot of bhajans, lot of singer you can invite, and those campaigns are required, and you create an ambience over there so that you get peace of mind. That peace of mind is very important. So because of that, people will be moving towards the temple. If it is aesthetically looking good, and people will be giving their visit, and you pay the entry fees, you have a lot of accessories. Danpatti, you pay money, you get nariel, you get flower, you stay over there. So any visit made by any person over there, at least they are going to spend in between 100 to 500 rupees. Even the entry fees you decide. Based on 2000 people visit initial level, you don't expect much people to visit. Even if you consider 2000 people are visiting your temple, spending money close to 100 rupees yearly, my calculation says that after giving everything, you have 70 lakhs rupees per annum you can earn. And that is tax free. No GST, no jhanjat, no nothing, absolutely you can get that money. But you make the trustee with your own close member, uncle, auntie, fufa, diska fufa, cha cha, bhatija, all those things you make a close member, so that whatever money comes, you give the third party audit, so you enjoy. So if you want to have the nice enjoyment in life, stress-free, this is the best business plan one can have. And I am 100% sure there is no failure, only success. You can have your home, BMW, car, Audi after 3 years. Now the 2000 will be going to get 10,000 visitors per day. It might come many temples or many church or many places, spiritual places, people are coming, they are earning millions of rupees. So friends, nobody, political leaders are not going to touch also. And in the name of spirituality or dharma, people are not going to touch you. So friends, it is very, very important, this business proposal, this our qualified people, if they want to succeed, again, I am telling, if they are interested, not on technology, simple life, earn money, lead a better life. you can secure your few generation good structural temple or masjid or girja, whatever you want to make it, you make it. Doesn't matter whether you belong to Hindu, Muslim or Christian, you are doing business, so you select the area and select the things and you do the business part. Let us not talk about the emotions when you are doing the business part. Friend, this is a fantastic business, I feel, and this is my suggestion to them who are not interested to get into very kind of a technology-oriented business or any other thing where they see some kind of risks are involved. So this is the only business that is existing in India, probably one can do it. And no jhanjat, you can manage political leader, GST return, no annual return, no quarterly return, nothing absolutely. So this business plan is with me. If anybody is interested, please contact me. Probably I can share the link. One can think over it and see how they can execute it. There are many qualified people there, frustrated. They are searching for job. So even if you have a home property having few acres of land, you can build a temple over there. It should be close to locality where you have the vicinity to access people. So that kind of exercise one can do. You get land free of cost. How much you are going to get from agricultural products doesn't matter. You built a spiritual temple or things over there. See the how the changes. There are a lot of associated industries are going to come up if you do that. Like let's say if you have developed a temple, there will be a nariyal will come, coconut will be coming, flower will be coming. There will be kaspool, pillow, balish, jhalmudi, chop, all those things. People will be, see, when they come to that place, after so much struggle they come, they will be very hungry. They need all those things. And those things are going to give you. So that how many industries people are talking about, if you are selling close to 200 chop, you can earn 50,000-60,000 or more than 1 lakh rupees per month. So what is the need of a scientist? What is the need of a doctor? What is the need of an engineer? Forget about all those things. At the age, after crossing 12th standard, you can have all those jhal mudi chop. You can earn money. That is what it is. It's very interesting things are happening. I'll talk to you all those issues separately. But my only apprehension is if you are interested to set up a temple rather than setting up an industry, temple is going to give you more return than setting up industry. There are situ, there are strike. After 6 months, you will see the people will be coming that give me bonus, give me increase my salary, increase my wages, and they will put a lal sticker over there. What you are going to do? So being as a businessman, you feel that your money should be secure. Only security is there if you build a temple or a masjid or a church or any other spiritual place for that matter. Friends, this is a very innovative idea. Nobody is going to give you, even Bill Gates. No one. All those people, great minds, they are into technology, but nobody is going to give you this temple business idea. So if you really want to know more about that part, please follow my link. You will get free of cost techno-economic feasibility report. And you execute it. You don't need a rocket science to do that. But I can assure you, your success is very much there. So if you want to be successful, follow that path. What's wrong in it? Thank you very much. Bye-bye. Take care.